Hello everyone, I am Sushmita Sarkar from RV College of Engineering. I welcome all of you in lecture 5 of our Power System Analysis 2 course, in which I am handling module 1. So in module 1, we have seen in our last lecture, that is, we have learned about bus incidence matrix. Fine, so in today's, I told you there is one more technique which we have to learn before going for formation Y-bus by singular transmission method, that is primitive network. So I hope bus incidence matrix is clear for all of you and hope all of you remember that. So let us go today and learn what do we mean by primitive network. Fine, so primitive network. So first we have to understand what do we mean by primitive element. So primitive element is an element which has no connection with any other element in the network. So like set of such unconnected elements is defined as a primitive network, okay? So very simple definition, don't forget that. It indicates you want to know the individual behavior of elements. So these elements are not connected to each other. So first you want to, because once you know the behavior of this individual element, then only when these elements are interconnected with each other, we can understand the complete behavior of the network. Fine. So these primitive networks are usually explained in impedance form or in admittance form. So if I'm going to explain this in the form of impedance, then you know how we are expressing it. That is, there's a passive element ZPQ between the bus P and Q, and you have a source that is called as EPQ, and you have a voltage across this particular element is VPQ, which is nothing but EP minus of EQ. Fine. So now if I have to express this whole single element into an equation form, what do I write? I write VPQ plus EPQ is equal to ZPQ into IPQ. Now, if I make this source as zero, okay, so basically I'm trying to understand a single element. When you inject a source over there, the flow of current, what is the equation? How does that particular element behave? So by understanding, I'm trying to understand this particular element, one keeping in an admittance form, one is in impedance form. So once I understand how this particular element behaves individually, then when I connect these elements into an interconnected network, I will be able to know the, how the whole network behavior will be. Fine, so now here it is, if I make this EPQ zero, so my equation will reduce to VPQ is equal to ZPQ into IPQ. Very simple, we all are very much aware about this kind of equation. Fine, so remember here all the terminologies which you are using is small letter because you are talking about an individual element, fine. Similarly, when I represent the same concept in admittance form, so I'm basically representing a primitive element in an admittance form. So how does it go? We know we replace the voltage source by a current source. So your current source over here is a ZPQ. So now the current which flows through this element is IPQ. So IPQ plus ZPQ will be giving you YPQ multiplied by VPQ. Fine. That's how we are seeing the equation of primitive network in admittance form. So here, if I make the source as zero, my equation will become IPQ is equal to YPQ into VPQ, okay? So I hope this concept is clear, representing a primitive element in admittance form and impedance form. Fine, so now to understand this example, so suppose I will be taking two such elements, okay, which are connected between two different buses. So what will be the network equation in such cases? Fine. So now I'm considering two admittances Y12 and Y34. Fine. So here it is your Y12 and I'm representing both in admittance form. So this is your Y12 and this is your Y34. So write the equation for both the elements in admittance form. So what do I get the equation, guys? I'm getting it as Y12 plus J12 is equal to Y12 V12. Similarly, Y34 plus J34 is equal to Y34 V34. I hope it is clear to all of you. Now, I want to write this in a matrix form. So it's very simple to write in a matrix form. I will be getting a matrix for current I, which is flowing through the element. I'm getting a matrix for the source current, okay, over here. and I get the voltage drop across the element, which represented over through this particular matrix. And this basically gives you the individual element passive value Y12 and Y34. Fine. So this off diagonal zero in any matrix represents that there is no interconnection between these particular points. Fine. So now this particular matrix is called as a primitive matrix. Okay. So in this particular case, since I have considered two elements, so the size of this matrix is a 2×2. That is the first thing you should notice. Second thing, which is very important to note, is that primitive matrix YPR is always a diagonal matrix. Okay. If there are no mutual coupling between the transmission lines exist. I repeat, if there are no mutual coupling exist between the transmission lines, then your primitive matrix will be always a diagonal matrix. Fine. So that's what I have written. So this particular matrix is 2×2. In general, n component network, the size of YPR is going to be n cross n. Fine. So where n represents your number of lines, because remember the YPR is with respect to lines. How many lines do you have? Because it talks about the individual behavior of the line, fine, or an element. So whether you write N cross N, whether you write E cross E, or you write L cross L, depends how do you define that particular letter, fine? So note YPR is a diagonal matrix as it is a set of unconnected elements, fine? So now what is the importance of this primitive matrix? We have already discussed, but let us see one by one. What is the importance of this primitive matrix? This matrices contains no information on the nature of elements which form the interconnected network. Okay. Next point. The complete behavior of the network can be obtained from the knowledge of the behavior of individual elements, which I have told you. An element in an electrical network is completely characterized by the relationship between the current through the element and the voltage across it, which we have seen in the equations in both the forms. And the last one, the matrices of interconnected network contain complete information about the network connectivity, orientation of the network, loops and cut sets. So basically, you people have not studied about loops and cut sets. This comes under network topology. Fine. So this gives you, once you know the behavior of individual element, then it is very easy for us to know the behavior of the complete network in all, keeping all these points in mind. Fine. So now let us go for an network variables in bus frame of reference. Basically, I'm going to define, or I'm going to derive a Y bus using singular transformation. So I hope you remember in my last lecture, I have explained you that why the name is given as singular transformation, because you are getting a Y bus, or you're forming an Y bus by using an A matrix. So A matrix is singular in nature. So you are transforming a primitive network with the help of A matrix into a complete interconnected network. So why I'm using A matrix? Because A matrix gives you an idea of, it basically tells you about the interconnection of the complete network. Lines are connected between which bus and all, what is the orientation of it. So exactly that's how the A, when you multiply it with the Y primitive multiplied by the A transpose, gives you the formation of Y bus. And that's what we called a formation of Y bus by singular transformation method. So exactly this can be derived by keeping bus frame of reference or loop frame of reference. But okay, we're going for a bus frame of reference because it's easy to understand. Fine. So primitive incidence matrix contains no information about the behavior of the network, which we have seen last. Okay. It only talks about an individual element. And hence it is necessary to transform the primitive matrices into more meaningful matrices, which can relate variables of interconnected network. So to understand that, so basically in this particular derivation, we are going to convert, or we are going to transform a primitive element into a completely interconnected network. So how to do that? So we know that our simple basic equation, that I is equal to Y into V. So here we are going to take it as I bus. this is a Y bus and this is a V bus. When you are talking about an interconnected network equation, all the letters you denote should be in capital, fine? So what is I bus over here? I bus is a vector of impressed bus currents, okay? V bus is the vector of bus voltages measured with respect to the reference bus. And Y bus is the admittance matrix whose elements are short-circuited driving point and the transfer admittances. We all know that what are the diagonal and off-diagonal elements of Y bus are called as. Fine, so now let us start our equation with the basic primitive network equation. So what is our basic primitive network equation admittance form? Yes, so I hope all of you remember that is I plus J is equal to Y into V, fine? I repeat, here all the elements we'll be considering as small because you're talking about a single element. Fine, so now I'm going to convert this single element or I'm going to transform the single element into a converted. So here we know what is the small y represents. Small y represents a primitive y bus. It is your YPR, fine, primitive y bus. So this is for only, this only indicates for the unconnected elements. So now when these unconnected elements connect with each other in a particular fashion, then what will be the capital Y bus formula? Fine, so for that we are going to start. So now what I'm going to do is, I'm taking the basic equation, fundamental equation as equation number one. I'm multiplying both the sides with A transpose. Fine, so all of you know why we are multiplying with A transpose, because A matrix gives me the interconnection of the elements between with each other. Fine, so why I take transpose? Transpose is taken just for mathematical reasoning, that is for multiplication purpose. Fine, I put it as equation number two. So now if you see over here that this particular component, that is AT of I, is a vector in which each element is algebraic sum of the currents through the network elements terminating at a bus, hence according to KCL, this particular term will be equal to zero. This is a basically current flowing in each element. So you know the KCL is, that is a summation of all the currents meeting at a junction or a point is equal to zero. So that is what we are taking, AT of I is equal to zero. Okay, then that's first term. So first term becomes zero over here. What about the second term? Second term is AT of J. So AT of J is a source current. So basically you are injecting a current into a bus, fine? So this is a source current. So source current, when I take the summation of all the source currents, I get it as I bus. That gives me the complete injected current into the interconnected network. So which we see over here, fine, which I told you. So AT of J will be, is I bus. So I put it as equation number four, fine? So now substitute equation number three and four in equation number two. So what was your equation number three? Your equation number three was AT of I plus AT of J is equal to, what is that? Y primitive, you remember? That is simple equation, A transpose Y primitive multiplied by, this is your equation number two. So here I'm going to put zero. Here I'm going to put I bus. So basically your I bus is equal to A transpose Y into V, okay? So, fine, so we get it over here like this. And I give it as equation number five. Next, now we know the summation of power at all the primitive networks should be equal to the power in your interconnected network, because when you transform from single element to interconnected network, power should be invariant. So transformation must be power invariant. So what do I write it as? I write this I bus transpose, I bus conjugate transpose, because you know complex power is always represented as VI conjugate. I repeat, complex power is represented as VI conjugate. So here you take the current conjugate. So this is my VI conjugate of the interconnected network. This is VI conjugate of the primitive network. Why did I took transpose over here? For the same reason, for the matrix multiplication, because if both are column vector, then you cannot multiply column and column. So one, you have to make it as row, and that is the reason we take the current as transpose. So you are taking as I bus conjugate transpose V bus, which gives you the total power in an interconnected network. And this is a power in your primitive network. Fine. So now what I need to do over here, I'm going to try to replace, okay, this I bus conjugate transpose. I'm going to try to replace this, my next step where I'll be replacing this I bus conjugate transpose. So how do I do that? So to do that, I will be taking care of this particular I put this as equation number 6. Let us see what we do in. Take conjugate transpose of equation 4. So what was your equation 4? Equation 4 talks about your, okay, so that is your ATJ I bus over here, equation 4. So take this equation, make it as I bus conjugate transpose because I want to replace this particular term. Fine. So why we are doing that, you will come to know. So now this is I bus conjugate transpose. So if you take this, this will become transpose and transpose will cancel out. You will get A conjugate and you will get J conjugate transpose. Okay. So what will happen? This J conjugate transpose over this side and this J conjugate transpose over this side will cancel out. Okay. Let us see what happened. Fine. So here I'm taking like this. Okay. So now one more thing, my A conjugate is equal to A. The question comes, how? How do you make A conjugate as equal to A? Fine. So A conjugate becomes equal to A. You remember the conjugate makes difference in your complex terms. Fine. Conjugate will make difference in your complex term, but A is a real matrix. Fine. So you remember your incidence matrix will have only 1 and minus 1. So the matrix is not at all complex. So the real, the conjugate of real number will be the same number itself. So you get A conjugate is equal to A. Fine. So I'm going to substitute over here and that A, so you get basically A bus conjugate transpose is equal to A into J conjugate transpose. So you are going to substitute this value in the previous equation. So what happens when you substitute this value of A J conjugate transpose over here, your J conjugate transpose and J conjugate transpose gets canceled out. So basically you get capital A V bus is equal to small b. Fine. So you will get it as capital A V bus is equal to small b. So this small b I'm going to replace in my previous equation. Where do I have put that small b? See, I'll go back and I'll show you where we require to put that value. So over here, can you check over here? So here you have where you put here already, I think in the next equation, that is your equation number. Here, fine. So I'm going to substitute the value of small v in equation number 5. Because my equation, in what form you want your equation? You want your form, you want your equation to be in the form of I bus is equal to Y bus multiplied by V bus. So I bus is already here. Fine. I need to replace this primitive in this whole, I have a primitive element V vector over here. So I have to convert this. I have to transform this. So the transformation of this, we got the value just now. V bar is equal to capital A V bus. So you are going to substitute that value over here. Okay. So I'm going to put substitute equation 8 in equation 5. So this is how I'm getting it. Like, so your equation is in the form of I bus multiply is equal to this particular term multiplied by V bus. So that means A transpose multiplied by Y primitive multiplied by A is nothing but your Y bus. So this is what you get, a formula for Y bus using singular transformation. So this is your bus incidence matrix transpose multiplied by Y primitive multiplied by incidence matrix itself. Fine. So please remember this formula, that how do we, what is the formula? Because using finding out a Y bus by inspection method is very simple. But by using a singular transformation, you need to use this formula. So where the order of A and order of Y should match. If these two order is not matching, then you will definitely go wrong in multiplication. Fine. Order in the sense, I'm not talking about the size. Obviously, size of both the matrix will not be same. but order should be same. Whatever element number you maintain for your incidence matrix, same element number you have to maintain for your Y primitive. Fine, so we'll see that when we do the problem. Okay, so quiz time. Fine, so let us take quiz one. The size of primitive admittance matrix, YPR, of a power system including half line charging admittance with N buses and N lines is equal to what? Fine, all of you know your YPR is E cross E. So what happens if your line charging admittances are present? Does your number of lines increases? First answer that question. Does your number of lines increases with half line charging or line charging admittances? Please recall your last lecture where we have explained, we have understood with one proper example. So please try to recall that example and think whether the number of lines increases with line charging admittance, yes or no. Okay, so answer is yes. Now the question comes, by what value the rows of that matrix will increase? By what, when your shunts are added into the system, by what value the size of the matrix should increase? Okay, if you remember, the answer is it should increase by number of buses. So you know the thing which you remember in white primitive matrices. First thing, YPR is a diagonal matrix. Second thing, YPR is a square matrix. Fine, so don't forget, YPR is a diagonal matrix. YPR is a square matrix. The size of the YPR is element cross element, number of lines cross number of lines. So your number of lines will get more or increased more when your line charging admittances comes into picture. Fine. So if I write a YPR value, the size of the YPR without line charging admittance, so as per this particular definition, if I denote that number of lines as L, so without half line charging admittances, the size of YPR is going to be, the size of YPR is going to be L cross L. Whether you say element cross element or you call line cross line, both means same. So as per the question been asked, so YPR is L cross L. But now if it is, this is in the case of a generalized formula where I have just written the generalized formula says L cross L. Now, if I say in your present network, if the half line charging admittance gets added up, then how does your size of YPR will increase? Okay, so size of YPR will increase with N plus L cross N plus L because your number of lines will get increased by number of buses. So your answer will be N plus L cross N plus L. So remember, those shunt elements also will be taking your diagonal place only. Fine. So for an example, to make this concept clear, fine. For an example, I'm just taking the same network example. I have a 3-bus system. I have a 3-bus system. So in this 3-bus system, how many lines I have? 3 lines. Fine. So your YPR will be 3 cross 3. So if it is a line 1, line 2, and line 3. Fine. So your YPR, how does your YPR will look? Fine. So if it is between, suppose this is between 1, 2, and 3. So I basically write it as small y12, fine. This is small y, it depends on how do you want to give a direct number or you want to write so that the picture is clear to you that it, this is a line between which particular bus. So this gives you y13, okay? And this gives you y23, So if I'm writing the line numbers in this particular, the admittances of these particular lines is Y12, Y13 and Y23. So how does my YPR looks? So your YPR, you know very much that it is your diagonal matrix. So go in an order as per given. If this is your line number one, so you get it as Y12, you get it as go as Y13 and you go it as Y23. Depends on how the number of lines are defined in a problem. So you go in that particular order. Y12, Y13, Y23. Our rest of diagonal elements are zero because Y primitive matrix talks about unconnected. It's a set of unconnected elements. It doesn't talk about the interconnection of these elements. Fine. So this basically right now is for you 3x3 matrix. Okay. But if the half line charging admittance comes, so if the half line comes, so you will be getting it as fine. If the half line comes, you will be getting it as the shunt at all the buses. Okay. Shunt value will also be added. Fine. So if I put this shunt values as Y10, Y20 and Y30, as this is my bus number one, bus number two and bus number three. Fine. So this, you know very much, this particular lines will also affect your A matrix. So A matrix also, if you are considering your shunt elements as the first in an order, then please in Y primitive also, you should consider them as a first only. Okay. It is not like that for A matrix, you are taking the shunt values as link, but whereas in Y primitive, you are putting them at the beginning, then you will definitely will get a wrong answer. You'll end up to get a wrong answer. So if you are considering, if you are making a tree with all the shunt elements, with the help of shunt elements, if you're making a tree, then you know your branches will come first and next will come links. So similarly, in this case, your Y primitive will go look like, fine, I will take the shunt value, Y10, Y20, Y30, Y12, Y13, and Y23. So basically, you get a matrix of 6x6, okay? So basically you get a matrix of 6x6, okay? So I hope it is clear for all of you that how the Y primitive matrix will get increased, the size of the matrix will increase with the addition of line charging admittance. Fine, question number two. A power system with 5 buses and 8 lines, compute the size of YPR and Y bus with and without line charging admittance. So guys, please tell, if it's a 5 buses and 8 lines, so all of you know, without half line charging admittance, Y primitive will be, first let us clear with Y primitive. Y primitive is going to be 8x8 without half line charging admittance. Fine. So look at the answer. We have it. Okay. Correct. Yes or no? What it will be with half line charging at, without half line charging admittance, directly it is given 8 lines. So directly we'll go for without half line charging admittance, YPR, the size of YPR will be 8x8. With half line charging admittance, what will be the size of YPR? All of you know that it becomes N plus L cross N plus 1, N plus L. So it will become 5 plus 8 cross 5 plus 8. So it will become 13 cross 13. Fine. So you can see that 8 cross 8 without half line charging admittance, and with half line charging admittance, it becomes 13 cross 13. What about Y bus? So you know, when the shunt is not, when your shunt values are absent, one of the existing buses will be taken as reference bus. So the size of Y bus will become N minus 1 cross N minus 1. So it'll become 4 cross 4. And when shunts are added, automatically you'll get the ground point. So size of the Y bus will become 5 cross 5. Okay. I hope the logic is clear. Let us see the question number three. Why YPR is a diagonal matrix? So all of you know that why YPR is called as a diagonal matrix, okay? Because it is a set of unconnected elements. It does not give you information of any interconnection between these elements. Hence, it is a diagonal matrix, fine? Okay, so let us go for problem one. So for a power system shown in figure below, Obtain Y bus using singular transformation method by considering bus 4 as reference bus. Fine. So this is the problem given. You are going to considering this bus, bus number 4 as a reference bus. So all the values which are representing right now are your impedance value. So first thing, your job is to convert it into an admittance value. So when we convert those element value into admittance form, so network is going to convert into admittance form. So I have taken the individual element 1 by Z. So you got it as this respective value, which is shown over here. Fine. Take the individual element inverse and make your matrix in admittance form. Sorry, make your network in admittance form. Fine. So now next, I'll go and plot a graph for that. So to go for a graph, let us have a clear picture of it. I have 1 to 2 connection, 1 to 4, 3 to 4, 2 to 4, 2 to 4 also I have, and 2 to 3 I have. Fine. So with this network keeping in mind, let us plot the graph. So this is your oriented graph. Okay. And the direction is given based on how, if the data are given. So suppose the data is given, the bus code is 1 to 2. So 1 to 2 means it will be away from 1 and towards the 2. Fine. So similarly, if it is given 1 to 4, it is away from 1 and towards the 4. So like take the orientation as per given in the table. And if the table is not given directly, your network is given with an orientation, then preferable take the orientation given to you, use the same orientation. Fine. So usually we prefer to give the orientation. Otherwise, it is difficult for a teacher to value the paper. Fine. So now for this A bus A matrix. So all of you have already understood in the last lecture that how we form an A matrix. So A matrix reference column should be deleted. So as per the question, references bus number 4. So bus number 4 is deleted. You see, you don't have a fourth column. I have only 3 columns and I have 5 buses, because this is the problem without half line charging admittance. So as per the given network, I have 5 lines and I have given the order as A, B, C, D, E, A. So as you give the order, write like that A, B, C, D, E. Okay, so where your ABC should give you a tree. Fine, ABC will give a tree. Let us see whether ABC gives me a tree or not. So this is your A, this is your B, and this is your E. Okay, so I don't know whether you're able to see my pointer or not. Fine, this is your 1 to 4. I'm covering your tree should be joining all the nodes without making a closed loop. So it is 1 to 4 going to 2 and coming to 3. Fine. So I have taken ABC. Sorry, this is an A. So I have taken ABC. So A to 1 to 4, 2 to 4 and 3 to 4. So this is a tree. Fine. So that is also a tree. So ABC will make you a branch and D and E will make you a link. Fine. So order is correct. Fine. So you know then if it is all ABC are towards A, B, and C. If you see A, B, C are towards the reference bus, because bus number 4 is reference bus. So definitely the fourth column would have been minus 1, minus 1, and minus 1. Okay. The column 1, 2, and 3 are away. The arrow sign is away from this respective buses. So all these are plus 1, plus 1, and plus 1. You can take D. D is between 1 and 2. So it is away from 1, 1 has to be positive and 2 has to be negative. So 1 positive, 2 negative. Similarly, E, in case of E, 2 has to be positive because it is away from node 2 and it's towards the 3. So 3 is negative. So I hope the matrix A is clear to all of you. Fine. So now let us go for Y primitive. So what I was trying to tell you in my last slides that if you have maintained an order of A, B, C, D, E, where A, B, C gives you a branch and the next two gives you a link, the order of Y primitive also should be same. Even in case of a Y primitive, you should write diagonal A, B, C, D, E. Okay, so let us see how it is. So you can see this is how I have marked A, B, C, D. If we go back, so Y14 will be your A. Fine, let us go back. Y14 is your A. What is your B? Y24. So let us see whether Y24 is B or not. It's your B. Similarly, Y34 is C and this is D and this is E. So the order has to be maintained same as your A matrix. Fine. So now we know the formula of Y bus. Y bus is A transpose multiplied by Y primitive multiplied by A. So you got the Y primitive matrix as well as A matrix. So now you start doing matrix multiplication. First, I'm going to multiply. You can do either these two and come back over here. And in this, how do you check the size? Guys, so in this case, what is the size of your A matrix? So because why I'm asking you this question, because many students find difficult while doing matrix multiplication. Fine, so to better way of understanding whether you are going right or wrong, check out the size of your each matrix. So in this case, what is the size of the A matrix? Your size of the A matrix is, fine, size of the A matrix is 5x3. Okay, so this is your size of the A matrix is 5x3. Fine, now let us go and check over here. So basically A transpose, okay, so basically A transpose is my 5x3. Why does this happens? Okay, so this is A transpose is 5x3. Okay, what is your Y primitive? Y primitive is, you can see over here, it is a 5x5. Sorry, A transpose is going to be 3x5. Is it? Fine. This is going to be 3 because it is a transpose. Fine. So it has to be 3x5. A transpose is going to be 3x5. YPR is 5x5. And A will be 5x3. Okay. So when you multiply these two terms, fine. So the when you multiply these two matrix, the inner values, you remove it. So what is the answer you get it as? When you do this multiplication, you get 3 rows and 5 columns. Okay. The answer of this, when you do a matrix multiplication, your answer should have 3 rows and 5 columns. So don't go wrong while doing a matrix multiplication. And this you get it as 5x3. Now you multiply that answer with a 5x3. This is still pending. You have to multiply with this. So basically now your inner value will go, 5 and 5 will go. So the final answer will be 3x3. Now this you can match with your regular method also, because the size of Y bus is n-1x n-1. So you have 4 bus in which 1 bus is a slack bus. So a reference bus, sorry, 1 bus is your reference bus. So that's how you get n-1x n-1. So 3x3 is your answer. Fine. So I hope I have, I'm able to clear this doubt of yours if anybody had that doubt. Fine. So now first I'll be calculating Y transpose into YPR. So we'll be getting an answer of this. And instead of substituting, it's always easier to substitute the value at the end. Okay. So you keep calculating the value. Just go back to the last slide. You keep putting, instead of putting the values which are given in the network, you write it in this particular format. Whether you write YA, it's not necessary that you have to do Y14, Y24, because it may take more time for you. Since in your graph, you have made A, B, C, D, E, in the same format, you can write also over here YA, YB, YC, YA, YB, YC, YD, YE. You could have written that also, fine. So you can make in that way also. And keep the parameters in the same format, multiply at the end, whatever answer you get, in that you substitute the given value. Fine, so I go back. So after that, A transpose YPR will give you this answer. This has to be still multiplied by your A matrix. Fine, so when you multiply this, you get this as Y bus. So you got the form with your formula, you got your Y bus. Guys, so you can check over here before substituting the values into this particular formulas, whichever you have got, not formula, in this particular expression, whatever you have got it for every element, please cross check with your inspection method. Remember, whether you form a Y bus by inspection method or singular transformation method, answer is going to be same. So you can always cross check your answer by doing an inspection method. And inspection method is very easy for us. Because as soon as you look at the network, you can directly tell whether your answer is right or not. Fine. So let us see. Before I substitute the value, I will first check whether this is correct according to my inspection method or not. So remember the first element. First element talks about Y14 plus Y12. Okay. So let us see. I will just, if I am remembering the network, let us draw the network over here. So side by side, we can go. So this is your bus number 1, 2, 3, and this is 4. Okay. Okay, and I have a connection between 2 to 4 also. Correct. So now you guys check by an inspection method whether it is right or not. So what will be your Y11? Okay. So this is your, what will be your Y11? Y11 will be Y12 plus Y14. Am I getting it over here? Correct. So this is right. Y11 is going to be Y12 plus Y14 by inspection method. What is going to be my Y12? It will be the negative of the series in admittance. So you are getting minus Y12. Fine. Do I have connection between 1 and 3? So you can see from the network, you have no connection between 1 and 3. So this term is 0. So we have checked. So it's correct. Fine. Since your matrix is symmetrical, just go for upper diagonal elements. Okay. Lower diagonal elements will be automatically correct because it is a symmetrical matrix. Fine. So here you see that the Y22, please cross check Y22. So what does the Y22 indicates? Y22 is which one? So Y22 is Y12 plus Y24 plus Y13. Y12 plus Y24 plus Y23. So this is correct. Fine. So you can go ahead. It's right. Next term is what? Y23. So Y23 exists. So the negative of this particular line impedance, admittance will be taken as minus Y23. So you get it as minus Y23. The last term which I have to cross check is Y33. So Y33 is nothing but Y23 plus Y34. So it's right. So whenever you reduce your expression in this particular format, cross check with your network by an inspection method. And after that, you substitute the values given in the problem, you will definitely get a correct answer. Fine. So here only you have to keep it in mind. Don't forget to convert the impedance data into an admittance, because if your questions, the data are given in the form of impedance, definitely few students will go in hurry and they calculate taking the impedance value and everything goes wrong. So read your data carefully, whether my data is in impedance form or in admittance form. Fine. I hope I made you clear the concept of making an or forming an Y bus by singular transformation method. Fine. So let us see one more problem. And if you have little bit more doubts, we'll clear it. I think this problem is with half line charging admittance. Yes. So I have taken this particular concept with the line charging admittance. Fine. So you have a network. I have this network. This network is not given in the problem. This network you need to draw by looking at the problem. Fine. So you have a Y bus where each series admittances are J2 ohms and the half line charging. Remember that it is written as impedance reactance. Fine. So the line values are given in terms of reactance. Reactance is nothing but the imaginary part of your impedance. So these are J2. So that's why you are writing J2. So these are impedance format, whereas the line charging admittances will be usually given in the form of admittance directly. Fine. So it is given a shunt admittance of 0.6 mho. So that is given, it is not mentioned as half. So you need to put it as half and put it both the sides. It's not required. This particular network, you can just to make students understand that how do we split the line charging admittance into at the end of the lines by divided by 2. Otherwise, directly you can put it in the bus and you can start doing your problem by taking it 0.6 more. Fine. So I was talking about this. Directly convert the complete. Don't forget to convert your reactances into your admittance. So this is what values we get it as, because all are 2J. So when you take the inverse, you get it as minus J.5. Fine. So continue right now. You can see. So your Y bus, let me ask you before going to the next step, tell me the size of A matrix. Okay, guys, With this, tell me the size of A matrix we have already done. So the size of the A matrix is going to be 6 × 3. Okay, size of the A matrix is going to be 6 × 3. And the size of Y primitive will be, you have totally 6 elements. Size of Y primitive is going to be 6 × 6. Fine. And the final Y bus is going to be, there are 3 questions I can ask. What is the size of YPR? What is the size of bus incidence matrix? And what is the size of Y bus? So A matrix size is going to be 6 × 3 because you have 6 lines and you have 3 buses, because the 4th point you get automatically due to the shunt values. Y primitive is going to be 6 × 6. You have 6 elements. And Y bus is going to be n − 1 × n − 1, where n is the number of nodes. So it is going to be 3 × 3. Fine. So let us see. Plotting the graph of this. Fine. So we have plotted the graph. Looking at that. So you can see that I have given the shunt values first as ABC. The shunt values are taken as ABC. Then DEF. So ABC will be your branches and DEF is going to be your link. So we do it so that you can go in an order and don't go wrong. So I can directly write in my A matrix ABCDEF. Fine. So this is your A matrix. I need not to explain how you get that. You all of you know already. And this is your Y primitive. So similarly, you know your ABC will act as a branches. So these are due to the shunt values. So Y primitive also should take care of the shunt values first. Okay, Y10, Y20, and Y230 represent your shunt values only, that because they are with respect to the ground. Fine. Next, you put the next of that. So DEF will be corresponding the same element. So don't get even confused by taking the links. Please follow the same order. D has to be Y12. This D has to be Y12. E has to be Y23. And F has to be Y13. Fine. So maintain the same order of A matrix and Y primitive. Then you know how to make an A transpose into Y primitive. You'll be doing in the same way. Then multiply A transpose YPR into A. Do it. And soon after this step, what did I told you guys? Check out with your inspection method. So all of you know that this looks correct, because here you can see your shunt value will be present in your diagonal elements only. So you can check your shunt values when you add this particular row. So all of you, when you add this particular row, your answer will be Y10. When you add this particular row, your answer will be Y20. Similarly, the last line, when you will get your add, will be Y30. So if the shunts are absent, your addition of all the row becomes 0 and the matrix becomes singular. Fine. This basic we have learned in the very first lecture. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. Immediately you get this particular Y matrix expression, immediately cross check with your inspection method and then substitute the value and check your answers. Okay, so I hope the concept of formation of Y bus with singular transformation is clear to all of you. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day. Bye.